As we go to air tonight, Prime Minister Anthony Albanese is meeting with his Spanish counterpart, the first of many high-level talks on a European tour dominated by the war in Ukraine. The crisis is the focus of the NATO summit, and today the battle-scarred country suffered more unimaginable losses with a deplorable and indiscriminate attack on a popular shopping centre in the east. TEN's Europe correspondent John Paul Gonzo is with the Prime Minister and has this story from Madrid.
Flames and fear. As Russia stoops to an unfathomable new low, a mall in Ukraine's east bombed in a rocket strike. It burnt to the ground. President Zelensky claimed up to 1,000 people were inside and said the number of victims was impossible to imagine. It is one of the most brazen terrorist acts in European history, he said.
This is a civilian target. This reinforces the atrocities being committed in this illegal war of aggression by Russia.
So far, the bodies of at least a dozen people have been found. The death toll will rise as firefighters clear the rubble. The attack comes as the eyes of the world are fixed firmly on Russia and as Prime Minister Anthony Albanese arrived in Spain for a NATO summit where allies are doing everything possible to ensure Ukraine wins the war. Australia may be 13,000 kilometres away, but the Prime Minister has made it clear what happens in Europe hurts us at home.
With rising petrol prices and the difficult issues relating to the supply chains,
NATO allies will agree to put 300,000 troops on high alert across Eastern Europe, the major security shift bolstering military borders around Russia.
This constitutes the biggest overhaul of our collective defence and deterrence since the Cold War.
The war in Ukraine will dominate this summit, but NATO is also turning its attention to China and how to deal with the country's growing influence in the Pacific.
Also in Spain, leaders from South Korea, Japan and New Zealand, what could be the start of a new Pacific pact to counter a common threat.
China has been prepared to make sanctions not just against Australia, but to be more aggressive in its stance in the world.
A world once again living through war as leaders try to prevent another one. John Paul Gonzo for 10 News First, Madrid.